to XCW Freetime Interview. I am Fletch. This is episode 2 here, 2020. We've got some new faces here in XCW, and I wanted to take the opportunity to talk to some of them. In this episode, I'm joined here by one half of the XCW Tag Team Champions, as of this recording, and a tag team called Heart of the Storm, alongside Deacon Storm, Blackheart. Thank you for joining me.
Thank you for having me. Appreciate it.
Let's get this fun started.
Let's do it.
You've been with XCW for a little while now. Mm-hmm. Pretty much two seasons now.
Yeah.
Who is your favorite XCW superstar to watch?
I had to think about it for a little bit, but I think Tommy.
Yeah.
Honestly, Tommy Merriman is a lot of fun to watch.
I cannot disagree with that at all.
There's a lot of fluidity to what he does in the ring, and it just, everything he does is so crisp, so, oh man.
Believable,
exactly, yeah, that's the word.
Yes.
He's very believable, and that's kind of one of the reasons I'd like to work with him one day.
Sure.
Because I feel like that would be a great match.
Well, speaking of people that you work with, mm-hmm. Who is an XCW that you most like to work with? I know that you've only had the opportunity to work with a select few, but to date, who's a favorite you've got a chance to work with?
Yeah, Tommy, I think, is top right now. I would love to have a match with Tommy. If Chris Jones had been with us this year, I would have loved to have a match with him as well. It would have just been interesting to be on this side of the super kick for once, because that's my finisher in XAWA, so...
I'm sure if you ever work with JJ, you're shoo-in.
Ooh, I wouldn't mind working JJ either, to be honest with you, JJ Kilty. DJ. I would love to work with DJ, actually, believe it or not. I want to work with everybody, let's be honest, but...
The only bad thing about DJ, I won't tell you this, and okay. I probably shouldn't, but DJ's biggest issue that I've had working with him is that he is light as a feather. And most of the time, that's good.
Right.
If I'm working with you, I don't want to be light as a feather.
Exactly.
But his size? Lay it in. Come on, man. 90 pounds? Lay it in. Hit me.
Yeah.
But,
I'm trying to hit me and hit me.
Yeah. Who's who in XCW? You just named, I think you and Tommy would be top-notch.
I would love. Oh, man.
Love to see that. You've been around, like we said, for a couple seasons, mm-hmm. whether you were involved in the show or working for the Tri brand. Right. I know you've watched some of the shows online. What, in your opinion, do you think was the best XCW show you've seen to date?
Ooh, I think it would have to be last year's Summer Mania for me.
Okay.
Summer
Mania is
that TLC
you go above
match.
And above and beyond.
Yeah, man. You absolutely do. Boy, that TLC match though, man, was something else. I knew from the moment I saw that German suplex to the announce table, this was going to be brutal as all get out, and it was. It was exactly that. And I actually had the pleasure of sitting ringside at that match because I was in a thing with Corey Lee at the time, but. Yeah, I got to see that match at ringside, and it looked just as brutal from ringside as it did to anybody watching at home.
Let's plug your YouTube here.
Okay.
If somebody came up to you right now and says, what is the absolute best XAWA show that I can find on YouTube? Let the XAW Galaxy know, what show should that be right now?
There's a lot of shows that aren't on YouTube that I would recommend, but right now, of the shows that are on YouTube, I think our best one right now is Anarchy Coliseum, the last year's. I think it was 7.
I did watch that. 7. Myself and Chris Jones, and we actually covered part of it on an episode of No False Finish, Season 3, Episode 1, where we talk about the FWL and XAWA in that episode. And
yep.
We talk a lot about Anarchy Coliseum in that, so check that out as well.
Yeah.
And also go to XAWA, check it out for yourself if you haven't seen it. It is a phenomenal show. I've seen it. Now, this is interesting, since the companies are kind of tied in. How did you get your start with XCW? How did this all come together?
The answer to that is tri-brand shows.
Sure.
Obviously, I think we all know by now that Will Smith was kind of instrumental in facilitating that
He's definitely the catalyst of that, yeah.
Yeah. We came down, I think the first time was November of 2018.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And we got involved in there, and we weren't as much of a part of the show at that point, just because we
can't tell Cyrus Mason that.
Right.
Now, if you watch that episode, you cannot tell Cyrus Mason that he wasn't the star.
That's true. No, that is very true. But, no, it was just kind of because it was a thing between you and FWO.
Sure, yeah.
Between XCW and FWO, and we were just kind of shoehorning ourselves in there in a way, in a manner of speaking. But as the tri brands went on, it got, like, way better. Like, the high-ranked tournament was probably, so far, has been the top tri-brand show, in my opinion, has been the top tri-brand show, just because of...
100% agree.
Everybody worked well together, everybody had a great time, we all made new friends that day, and there was some great matches at that show as well, including the main event itself, Cyrus Mason and Genocide. I thought that was a fantastic match.
Speaking of fantastic matches from the tri-brands, if you haven't seen it, go watch the United Championship match between Nightmare and Genocide.
Oh my god,
phenomenal.
Yes.
But, yes. In my opinion, that was not a very good show. High Rank was a hit and miss.
Yeah.
With that being said, what, in your opinion, was the worst show experience you've ever had in backyard wrestling?
See, I've been around for a while, so it's hard to nail one down, but man.
XAWA started, what, 2011?
We started as XAWA in 2011.
Okay.
With two combined organizations, AWA, XWA, and the AWA started in 2002.
Okay. Which company were you in?
I was in AWA.
Okay.
That's
where
we started.
Were you the
yes.
owner-operator of that? Okay.
Yes. And then Cyrus Mason was the owner-operator of XWA, which
okay.
started in 1999.
So, oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah. So, you know, we have, like, a rich 20-year history supporting us if you combine all the histories
sure.
of all the
yeah.
companies. But, yeah. It's very hard to pinpoint what was the worst experience. We've had a few. Oh, you know what? I can tell you of one incident I thought was like a pretty bad moment where we had. Okay, so you probably know about our relationship, quote unquote, with RCCW.
Uh-huh.
They've trained.
That's out of Richmond, right?
Yes, mm-hmm. It was. It closed down December of last year. So,
okay,
but they trained, and I use that term very, very, very loosely.
You're a referee there, right?
I am a referee. Yeah, I was a referee there. And I think there's a new organization sprouting up, and they've already offered me a position as a referee.
Awesome. That's, okay.
That's neither here nor there. And I know those guys now, and it's nothing like it was back then. So it's
sure.
like, it's definitely, they've warmed up to me, and they've kind of, you know, they're not antagonistic anymore. But in fact, a couple of their guys still work on our roster. So Sergeant Dowell was one of them. The worst show experience, we had some people come in from RCCW, and actually we had one of them named Havoc. He was a special referee for a triple threat match that we aired on, this was April of 2012, I think, I don't remember the exact date, there's too much in here. but it was April 2012, and we had a triple threat match, and it was between Sean Havoc. We had a Havoc as well. X and Hitman Cox. And Hitman Cox took a chair shot to the head that split his head all the way open. Blood everywhere. He ended up having to get 9 staples in his head.
And
that was rough for just about everybody. Because we at that point, we'd never, like...
Had that kind of sustained
yeah.
injury. Yeah.
Yeah. It was kind of difficult to watch. It's gotten a little easier with time and the fact that the guy that plays him is kind of a dick, but it's still kind of hard to watch. Even 8 years later, it's still kind of hard to watch. That shows up on YouTube somewhere, too.
So, again, you've only been in the XCW realm for the last 2 years, but what was the biggest moment and the biggest turning point in XCW since you've been around?
Honestly, the tri-brands. I think getting more groups of people together to kind of put on these super shows is expanding our horizons here.
Sure.
Not just for XCW, but for everybody. Oh, the XAWA, the FWL. It's expanded everybody's horizons, and it's allowed these business relationships. It's allowed these new wrestling matches that nobody would have ever thought would have been possible before, and. Yeah, that right there is, that's tops.
Yeah, absolutely. And who would have thought, I mean, even going back 2 years, that they're, I mean, these backyard companies, we don't even know that each other exists. And then
right.
once it happens, and then it's just, It's an automatic brotherhood. I mean,
yeah,
Backyard is few and far between, and you know, when it's beautiful when these companies get to come together like
and
this.
And when you start working with somebody that you don't know, and you're always going to be a little apprehensive. But when we came in, we started working with you guys. It's like, I mean, we're more alike than anybody knows. Like, because they goof around, we goof around. Like they get stuff done, we get stuff done. It's the same stuff. So it's like, it's like, you know, a giant family.
Two-parter kind of here.
Okay.
Biggest turning point in your career, and then your separate answer, biggest turning point in your XCW career to today, which I know has only been about half a season, but biggest turning point for yourself and your career, and then also for your career in XCW.
Biggest turning point in my career would have been the return to XAWA. Well,
leave from XAWA?
When I left wrestling originally was in 2008, and it wasn't combined yet. It was still two separate organizations.
Okay.
They combined in 2011 without me. I was living in Austin, Texas at the time. I was not a part of the roster. I was not even anywhere near it. They decided to do it, and I watched. I watched the shows. I was very, very supportive, and I came back in 2012 and re-debuted on the roster.
I would have never pictured an XAWA show without a Blackheart.
Yep. That whole first year of XAWA, after the merger, there's no Blackheart whatsoever.
So who's running at the time? Is that Cyrus Mason?
Cyrus Mason and Cryptic.
Do you have that footage now?
Yes. The entire year, I have it. The whole year is in my archives, and it will be going up on the XAWA channel in due time. So I'm slowly trying to get those uploaded.
I have a lot of the UIW footage. Company Justin Parsley, pretty much a mortal enemy of mine, ran for a little while. I have all of the footage from that, and then I also own all of the EBW footage. So I understand. Yeah. I mean, there's been a lot. I mean, there's been, I'd say, every bit of 8 or 9 backyard companies right here in Shelbyville, and XW is the only one that stood the test of time.
Yeah, and to get back to your question, when I came back in 2012, I hadn't wrestled a match in 5 years. Wow. So I was wondering if I could even, you know, still do it at that point in time. And there was people on the roster that I'd never worked with. We had people like, people watch this probably aren't going to be familiar with some of these names, but Xander, which is somebody I loved working with. Once I started working with him, Adrian Hollow was on the roster back then. He was under a different name, Three
Bonkers,
Steps.
Right?
Bonkers, he didn't become Bonkers until later in 2012, but he was Three Steps to Death, was his name when I re-debuted.
That's a good team name. I don't know about that. I don't know, single person name, but...
Yeah, I think that's probably why he changed it, honestly.
In my opinion, I guess.
Yeah, but. I didn't like the name Three Steps to Death either. I thought it was a little corny, but I love the Bonkers character. The Bonkers character was fantastic. I would give a leg and a half to get that character back. But Adrian Hollow was a great character too, so you know.
Big turning point in your career is coming back?
Coming back, wondering if I could still do this thing that I love doing, and as it turns out, I was able to still do it. I've had some great, fantastic matches with people, and I've had some great matches with Will Smith. I love wrestling Will. I love wrestling Nightmare. I love wrestling Cyrus Mason.
XCW turning point.
Winning the tag championships.
Absolutely, yeah. I mean,
yeah, for me right now.
No brainer right now.
Yeah, no brainer.
What's the worst injury you've sustained in your long career?
Well, knock on wood. I'll just do that real quick. Sorry about the camera shake. I've never really had a major injury, thank goodness.
That's great.
The worst thing I probably did was I probably bruised a rib. And that's honestly, I don't know how I've managed to go almost 20 years and not get hurt.
That's great.
Super seriously.
I cannot say the freaking same, trust me.
Maybe a concussion, but even that, you know, I take precautions. Well, I don't, because I always do the hand thing when I do headshot.
I think I got so hurt like, twice in like last show, so.
Yeah, so I'm extremely fortunate that with all the crazy stuff that I do, and if you've watched anything from XAWA, you'll know that I put myself through hell. I agreed to a barbed wire match with Will Smith.
Yep.
And that did not feel good. But somehow, the worst we got from that was scratches. And I don't know how.
Speaking of worst,
doing that.
What's the worst injury you've witnessed?
Yeah, that's got to be Will. And then we're at, okay. So let me tell the story about this because this I was literally in Gorilla in XCW with the music and running that, and JJ was standing there. JJ Kilty was standing there with me, and we were peeking through the curtain watching Will climb this ladder, and we were like, that ladder's not open all the way, that ladder's not open all the way, and then he took the jump, and he did the flip, and, like, hazard, thank God for him, because his, like, quick thinking made sure that he didn't land on his head, because it could have been so much worse, but when we heard that thump on the ground, and we were, like, 5 feet away, and I was like,
shh. And it sucks, because, you know, the match is still going, and you're hopeless, like, you can't do anything.
And thankfully, like, the match was, like, ended, like, right after that, but Brogan got through the curtain, and I was like, get back through the curtain, Brogan, goddammit. Because we had to get, and then, we thought Will was going to be okay at first, and then I ended up having to take him to the hospital later that night, so, it was like, that was rough, having to sit there next to him in the hospital bed.
Absolutely, and you know that Will Smith has walked away from wrestling, for now.
For now. He's recovering, thank goodness.
He walked away from wrestling for now, but what about you? We know that you took a hiatus, and then came back in 2012, as you said, right?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
But has there been a time since 2012 that you've consistently been in XWA or even XCW where you ever just wanted to walk away from business for good?
Yeah, and we tried to. 2014. We actually tried to. 2014.
We did 16, so.
Yeah, 2014 was our final season. Final season, quote unquote. Obviously, it's not, but it was supposed to be.
We had a show called Until the End, so.
Yeah, literally, like Anarchy Coliseum 5, that subtitle of that show was The End. Like, literally, that was the subtitle of it. But we went all out. We decided, screw it. And I think that's kind of why we have the approach to the show that we do today, is that we just decided, because we thought it was going to be our last year, we were done. Screw kayfabe. We're just going to break kayfabe. We stopped in 2014, and we came back July of 2018.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. We wrestled two reunion shows in between those two.
And that didn't re-spark anything, those reunions?
The first one didn't, although I had a really fantastic match with American Hillbilly where he moonsaulted off of a shed onto me, so.
Wow, you guys were committed to being gone.
The first one didn't spark a thing. The second one did. The second one absolutely sparked a thing. I had a 45-minute match with Nightmare where we beat the piss out of each other. And I was like, okay, I gotta get some more of that, because I'm an idiot. So
2008, XW had a show called The Farewell Show, and people thought it was the end of XCW, but as a matter of fact, it was a kind of a farewell to some of our other guys who were going off, like Dylan Bostick. I'm sure you've heard that name thrown around a lot.
Yes, yeah.
He was leaving the company. He was pursuing things more professionally, and we had some other guys that were on their way out. It was kind of a farewell to them, but to the loyal XCW guys, it was a re-spark.
Yeah.
And for the fact that, oh my God, this might be gone, just rejuvenated everybody. We were back by that November, and that was in July.
Yeah.
And then Until the End, similar thing, but Until the End, I honestly had no... I had no intention on ever coming back.
That was our intent, too.
Yeah,
2014 for us was like we were burnt the hell out.
May of 16, we were done.
We had decided the year previous at 2014.
March 17, here we are, reunion.
Yeah.
And no stopping us since.
But yeah, we broke. 2014 was the year. If you watch anything from 2014 for XAWA, and there's some up already and some will be re-airing soon, kayfabe is not a thing that year because we decided screw it. We had a character called DC that we actually literally killed off in the ring. We had Nightmare snap his neck in the middle of a match. And sometime during 2014, he just randomly walks by camera. Like nothing ever happened. Like he wasn't dead in a pile of ash. We actually brought him back out for the match following his death, put the alien mask on him, and he wrestled as a zombie. That's how weird it was. We decided, screw it, we were done. We thought we were done at that point.
Well, with that being said, what was the worst gimmick? That sounds like it stands the test of time.
I don't know. Zomb Alien was entertaining at the least. I wouldn't call the alien a bad gimmick. It's a weird one for sure. Because we got to the point where the guy who plays him is Will, and originally, and we got to the point where he couldn't be there every show, but we had his mask, so we decided, screw it, that mask is the alien now, and anybody who wears him is now the character. Okay. So that's how we got around that, but. Worst character, as much as I have come to kind of enjoy the shenanigans, Cardboard, I definitely did not like that character at the outset, and I made it very well known that I thought it was stupid. But, that being said, it is an entertaining stupid.
What about best?
Best gimmick? That's hard to say. I've seen a lot of gimmicks come and go.
XCW, then.
XCW best gimmick?
Who's got the best gimmick right now?
Venom. Absolutely Venom. Giant mountain of man. He's a monster. He runs through the whole roster. That makes sense. It makes a lot of sense. I like that gimmick.
Is there any pre-match rituals or any way that you prepare for a match?
Well, you've seen my pre-match rituals because I tend to go around like super kicking people or pretending to super kick people. That's actually me stretching, believe it or not. But like, yeah, I tend to do that a lot, and just especially when I come to an XCW show because I don't do that move in XCW because that's Chris Jones' move. I'm trying to be respectful, so
right.
I get all my super kicking out before the show starts. But yeah, even in XAWA, before a show, I'll throw super kicks at people just randomly, and you know nobody sells because I don't expect them to. But but when the camera's on, motherfucker, you better
sell. Speaking of sell, this is something you've got to sell. You have no choice.
Okay.
What is the worst chop you've ever received? Who was it?
I've had a lot. It wasn't even in XAWA or XCW. It was during my time, actually in ring. I did some in ring stuff with RCCW back in the day, and it was in the middle of a battle royal, and they literally pulled the shirt up over my head, and to the point where, and it was me and Cyrus Mason and the Ogre were in there, and Sean Hammock were in there, and all our chests looked like black.
Ugh.
By the end of it, Chris's, Osiris's looked the worst. His like full dark black and like it's like ugh. Most of us were just like dark purplish, but it was ooh.
You were talking a little bit about your pre-match ritual, super kicking, and you talked about Chris Jones the super kick in XCW. But what, in your opinion, is the best finisher in XCW right now?
The best finisher in XCW right now. I think I gotta go with Tommy's F5.
Okay. He calls it the Cyclone.
The Cyclone, mm-hmm. Right. And I've seen a great many people do that move.
No love for my final breath.
And Nightmare does the move too in XAWA. We call it Wake Up Screaming. I actually personally named that move, by the way.
Pretty damn good.
Yeah.
We're calling Hayden Vex's finisher in XAW. The Bloodline.
Yep. Yeah.
So, look at him. Lucky guy, getting all the cool names.
Right?
Son
of a bitch.
Growing up, who was your biggest wrestling influence on watching pro wrestling?
I have the standard answers to this, which are like the Shawn Michaelses. And the,
sure.
And the, like, to some extent, obviously, with who I am, the Mick Foley's.
Yeah.
But I loved, my favorite thing to watch when I was a kid and when I was watching WWF back in those days was the hardcore division.
Yeah.
So I'm a massive fan of Steve Black. You will not find.
Big Boss Man?
I love Big Boss Man. You will not find a bigger Steve Blackman mark than me. I love the Lethal Weapon Steve Blackman.
I think people were shocked by my answer to that question. My answer was actually Bo Ray Dudley. We have a similar body style, and so he was a big influence for me.
And you know what? I can see it, and I'm not really that shocked by that answer, honestly. I liked him too. I loved that. I didn't even get it. I didn't get into original ECW until it was almost closed, but I went back and watched it. And I love that stuff, man.
Bubba Ray Dudley's been through so many concept matches in his time.
Yeah.
What is your favorite concept match?
That's a tough one. The one I love doing the most is Texas Deathmatch, which when we do it in XAWA, it's basically a last man standing match, but in order to start the 10 count, you have to pin the opponent. So sure. It's a pinfall into it.
We have a death match in XAW, it's a little similar, but it's only last man standing rules. There's no pin.
Right.
But, you can't top a death match for sure.
Yeah, exactly.
Especially being a hardcore fan like yourself.
Yeah.
That's it. But with that being said, death matches come with weapons, you know. What's the hardest weapon shot you've ever received?
I don't even know if I can answer that one. I've been hit with everything, dude.
I got hit with a corner of a box fan. That was actually pretty bad once.
I've been hit with a fan. I've been hit with wiffle ball bats. I've been hit with barbed wire, light tubes, thumbtacks. I've been hit with kitchen sinks.
Chris Jones told me one time, the worst thing he's ever taken, there's two things, and I believe him. One was a windshield wiper. The other one was a fishing pole.
Oh, I'd do it. I would do it in a heartbeat. But that's just me. You know what?
Keep Blackheart out of the extreme title picture. I got it.
Yeah. I'll get in there and take some shots. Well,
speaking of XCW and the extreme title, are you going to have the opportunity to become the extreme champion? Are you still going to be in the tag team division? What do you think holds the future for you in the next 6 months in XW?
Well, I'd like to continue being the tag champs, obviously. But I would love a little bit of that extreme championship action. Yeah. I am the longest reigning XAWA. I have the longest combined reigns as XAWA hardcore champion. And I have the most reigns as hardcore champion. I'm currently I'm still champion as of this video. And I won it back at... I won it off of Corey Lee back in October. Yep. So I still have it. And as of this video, I am a 21-time hardcore champion with almost 500 combined days as champion.
Wow.
So, yeah. Give me in that extreme division, I'll tear it up.
Speaking of people tearing it up in XCW, there's a lot of new faces in XCW. Who, in your opinion, is the fastest rising star in the company right now?
Let's see. Fastest rising star right now has got to be, let's see. I'm scanning through the roster in my mind to try to figure out the correct answer to this. And at least in my opinion, the correct answer. Fastest rising star is Brogan O'Shea.
I can't disagree
with that. Fastest rising star is Brogan O'Shea. I'm torn between him and DJ because DJ is really good too. And
absolutely.
I think he's a fast rising star in his own right. But Brogan O'Shea has come
to you. Got one as international champion. The other one is Money in the Bank. You can't go wrong with that.
Yeah.
Brogan O'Shea is a very unique character, a very unique name. But who, in your opinion, has the best rename in XCW?
Best ring name in XCW. I'm a fan of the Hayden Vex name. I love that name. And a bunch of us were throwing around name ideas. Like,
yeah.
Not even just you. Like, it was us, too. Like, right. I was throwing out name ideas. The Ogre from XAWA was throwing out name ideas. And we settled on something that I think everybody's a fan of.
Yeah.
I love that name, Hayden Vex.
With that being said, a lot of newer guys coming in, a lot of newer faces. Out of some of the newer faces in XCW in the last few years, who do you think deserves to be in the Hall of Fame that you know, in the future? Who needs to be a Hall of Famer? Who deserves it?
I do feel DJ is a future Hall of Famer.
Yeah.
He is top tier.
One of the most dedicated.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. What you see on camera is basically what he is off camera, too.
Sure.
He lives the gimmick.
Yep.
He lives the gimmick.
One thing that DJ, I associate DJ with is his style. It comes off to me, like some musicians in the world, you know, Chris Motionless and Marilyn Manson. And I absolutely love your theme song.
Oh, thank you.
But what...
A lot of people do. A lot of people do, apparently.
What theme did you use in your career that you just enjoy the most?
The current one. Renegade by Head Planet Earth. And apparently a lot of people like it, because after I was here for the first Tri-Branded show in November 2018, I don't know how many people came up and asked me, what is your theme song, because I want to download it. I love that theme song. I actually, when I came back, I've used a lot of different ones, but when I came back in 2012 to XAWA, I started using that song, and I've never changed it. I changed it once when I was a heel, and I was only a heel for like a month. So, it's always been Renegade by Head PE.
Speaking of being a heel, what do you prefer, face or heel?
Face.
Really?
I like being a heel. I do. I think it's a lot of fun.
That's Hazard's answer. They're like the only other person I've ever heard say that.
I don't know.
Being a heel's easy.
Being a heel is easy, and I do enjoy it, but it's hard. I've just been a face for so long that it's just kind of second nature to me.
And here in XW, we have a saying talking about our camera. It's the eye that never blinks.
Mm-hmm. Shoot some contact lens solution for that.
Yeah. Were you ever shy being in front of a camera? Were you ever shy?
Probably very early on. It'd have to be like somewhere around early 2000s for that. But see, the thing is like, I got comfortable real quick just because I love the idea of filmmaking and, even outside of XAWA and XCW, I love filming. Like, there's never a moment where I'm like, I don't want to film, because I always want to film. I'm always hot to shoot something. So it got to the point.
Guilty.
Exactly. You know how I feel.
Ta-da!
It got to the point where I was just like, yeah, you know what? It's fine. And eventually I just got real comfortable, and now it's just like, sometimes I don't even care if the camera's there. So... Yeah, it became second nature at some point in time. Because if you're going to be a filmmaker, if you're going to do this stuff regularly, you got to get rid of the shyness. You got to throw the cloak off, so to
speak. Absolutely, yeah.
Because otherwise, it's not going to be fun. So once you throw the cloak off, it's fun.
Now, you talked a little bit about your time in independence and your start with your company before XAWA.
Mm.
Did you have any wrestling experience before that, and who were you trained by?
I had no wrestling experience before starting in 2002. I got a little bit of training, quote-unquote, from RCCW in 2006. Went back several years later, more training. Really, the majority of the good training that we've gotten has been from here. So, and I know that's weird to say, because I've been doing this for such a long time. For somebody who's been doing it for 15, 16, 17, 18 years to come in and still say, hey, you know, I could use this training. I mean, I always need tune-ups, you know.
Sure.
There's never a moment in time where I'm like, okay, I'm satisfied with what I'm doing. Let's go on that. No, there's never a point where I'm satisfied. I always want to get in there and get bumps in.
Short answer here.
Mm-hmm.
You don't know much about XW's history, but just in the last year or so, and current, who do you think stands out as a top team?
Starstruck. Which...
Give them the nod to the rise, huh?
Listen, a lot of people might not think, given the way we conduct ourselves on camera... that we respect them, but I have a ton of respect for both of those guys. Corey Lee was one of the first XCW people I ever got to work in a ring, and I enjoyed working with him so much that we made a friggin' angle out of it.
Right.
And Brendan has been the same way. He's been a lot of fun to work with, and we had a singles match a while back that, I mean, it wasn't, I don't think it was the greatest, because I know there was things that I didn't do well, and there was some timing issues, but I thought we did fairly well, considering... I think that was the match that Aaron took a ref bump, I believe, on top of me almost, literally. and I enjoyed that, and I thought it was fine. Like, I didn't think there was anything too major wrong with that. But I love working with both of those guys, and I have nothing but respect for both of them.
You talk about respecting Corey and Brendan, rightfully so. But is there anybody that you just personally just do not like?
whose hand was that just went up? The answer would be from the XAWA roster, and there's a couple of people that, like,
Okay.
I did not click very well with, we had a character named Hitman Cox. His gimmick was that he was high all the time, but he was a pain in the butt to work with, and eventually, finally, when he left, I was like, so glad to be rid of him. We also have a character named Shade, who, let me tell you something about that guy. He was extremely difficult to work with. If he wanted to work with you, you could have a great match with him. I have seen many people have a great match with him. Watch any match between Cyrus Mason and Shade in the last... They've been wrestling forever. Those two have had a feud that has gone on for 15 years. And every match they do, they legitimately knock the dog shit out of each other. To the point where they sometimes just knock each other the hell out, and legitimately. I think most recently they had a match where literally Mason hit him over the friggin' head with a pane of glass and just shattered him, cut him open, and eventually he ended up not... Shade is...
Sounds like a Hazard Jesse Justice match.
Yeah, a little bit. But Shade was just notoriously difficult to work with. He always wanted a title shot this, title shot that, even if he didn't deserve it. When we were just XWA and AWA, he was a part of AWA, and because of his politicking, he was AWA World Heavyweight Champion for 2.5 straight years.
Wow.
He would not drop that belt. He dropped the belt, in that period, he dropped the belt twice and only for a week each time. Once to Cyrus Mason... And Mason wasn't even on our roster at that point, and once to a gentleman called Blade, who, by the way, is one of the best people I've ever worked with also. But it finally took him a lot of convincing. He finally dropped the belt to me in early 2008, and then after that, like, nothing ever really happened. So we didn't even have that much of a season then. So, but he was also notoriously difficult to work.
You've watched some XCW back online. You've been with XCW for a very short period of time. Mm-hmm. But so this might be a little difficult to answer, but what is the best rivalry or storyline that you've seen play out in your time in XCW?
That's a good question. That latest Venom storyline... With Chris Jones. I enjoyed the hell out of that. There was a lot of good storytelling in that.
Sure.
Also, Fletch and Tommy. Was it you and Venom that had the... It was you and Venom at Summervania, right?
Yes.
That Clockwork House? Yeah. Where you got slammed on the Legos. That looked like fun.
Yeah.
I would do that, probably, and regret it. I'm going to go with Venom and Chris Jones on this one. Just because it was a great story, it was nice, it was well told, and the surprise was great, and at the end of it all, they had a fantastic match to close out the year. So, you know, that was kind of perfect in my eyes.
What kind of legacy do you think that XCW is going to leave behind, or XAWA, both, or maybe even combined? Backyard wrestling in general.
In general, I feel like... I'd like for us to be remembered, both of our organizations to be remembered as the best, with the best talent, the best writing, the best storylines, the best production work that you'll ever see.
I need to brush up on that, but...
I mean, I'm not going to talk shit about production work. I've been there and done that. I have been there in the doldrums using, like, Windows Media Player or Windows Media Editor and that crap, so I can't talk crap about that, but... that's what I would like to remember. It, you know, we had great wrestling, great storylines, memorable characters, you know, that sort of thing.
What about you personally? What legacy do you think you're going to leave behind in XCW?
I feel kind of like I'm hoping it's the same one I've kind of carved out for myself already. I tend to be known as somebody who enjoys hardcore wrestling, and I wouldn't mind... that being my legacy, honestly.
Okay.
I would not mind that being my legacy. Being known for being the guy who will literally put his body through just about anything for entertainment's sake.
Sure.
So I hated doing that barbed wire match, but I did it because I thought it would be entertaining. And it ended up being our match of the year last year in XAWA. So.
What kind of impression do you think XCW is going to leave on your life, personally?
Well, personally, I'm just glad to be a part of an organization that I don't have to fucking control. so
I will never XCW
has actually just been easier for me because I don't have to worry about... I get to sit back and enjoy it. I get to sit back and enjoy it and actually, you know, just be like, okay, cool, I'm doing this today. I'm fine with that, you know? it's nice to be able to sit back and relax and come to a show and just, you know, hey, this is what you're doing, this is what you're who you're wrestling today, and I'm like, cool, send me out there, let me do it.
I'm sure you're going to accomplish many great things here in XCW.
I would love to.
But what, in your opinion, is your biggest backyard wrestling achievement to date?
Ooh, that's a tough one because I got a lot of moments to choose.
Pick one. One, what is the biggest?
Yeah,
XCW Tag Team Champion.
I think the first time I won the XAWA World Title. That was
what
top so
that?
Far. Oh God! You have to give me a second because I think that was 2012, and that was interesting.
The first year you came back.
Yeah, it was, and it's a funny story. And funny enough, I actually dropped it to Nightmare later on. That's the fastest rising superstar that we've ever had, but. That was a funny story, by the way, how I came to be World Heavyweight Champion. I didn't exactly come by it the normal way. I was in a storyline with a man called Xander. We were building up a storyline between him and me where I would wrestle his buddies. And if I win, I get 5 extra minutes with him in an Iron Man match. We started with a 5-minute Iron Man match. And every time I beat one of his friends, I would get 5 more minutes.
Wow.
And
okay.
When we finally got to... Redemption was the name of our supercard back then. Yes, I know you have one too, but we also had a show called Redemption. It was in September 2012. When I got there, I had beaten five of his friends and gotten 30 minutes. So, we've talked personally, you and I, about, you know, controversy, pushing boundaries, pushing envelopes.
Sure.
We had a lot of people who would, and it's not even that controversial because it happens in pro wrestling all the time, blading.
Sure.
People would, you know, cut themselves, bleed, you know,
right.
For the sake of, you know, getting color.
Right.
And we don't tend to do that as much anymore. We do use stage blood. I wouldn't say it's fake blood, but it's stage blood because it looks realistic, and we've used that a lot, but... back then, we would go ahead and do the blading, and there was a couple of people that didn't sit well with, and one of those was Xander. And when we geared up for our Iron Man match, we did it was like the match was going to happen. We went out there, we filmed the entrances, we got out there, Xander took the belt, dropped it at my feet, turned around, walked away, got in his car, and drove off. And because of that, we made the decision to go ahead and give me the belt, and that was... Yeah, I wasn't a fan of his after that for a little bit, but we patched up after that eventually, and yeah. But I defended that title every single week and made sure that the reign actually meant something, and that's why I feel like that was a top achievement for me. It's because, like, I took a moment that wasn't so great and tried to make the best out of it, and then eventually dropping that belt to Nightmare.
Making a new star.
Exactly.
Right.
So... Yeah, I will never not enjoy making moments like that. Even if I'm on the shit end of the stick, so to speak. Like,
assuming you've been Blackheart, I know you had a couple incarnations. You had Eric Blackheart and all that. Where did you come up with the name and gimmick?
Funny enough, I started as just Mike way back in the way, and that's dumb, by the way. That's a dumb wrestling name. Never do that. Stop it.
We have just Cody.
So, similar to how Nightmare came upon his wrestling name, have you ever played it's WrestleMania 19 on the GameCube?
I have. It's been a long time.
You know about
time,
the story mode in that one, right?
I'm a little shaky on it.
It's you're basically trying to destroy Vince McMahon's empire because they kicked you out of the company.
Okay.
But there's boss characters in that game and that you can unlock. And one of those boss characters is named Eric Blackheart. Believe it or not.
Hmm.
So, when I played that game for the first time...
Is it spelled the same way?
Yep.
Huh.
Yep, spelled the exact same way. So, I saw that name and I'm like, I love that. I got to use that. So it became Mike Blackheart for a while. And then I decided to drop the mic because I didn't like how it sounded. And then I became just Blackheart. And then I think it was literally a throwaway line mid-2014 where we were wrestling and somebody on commentary called me Mike Blackheart. I'm like, why do people call me Mike? That's not my name. Eric is my name. Literally a throwaway line, but that's where that came from.
Is your even your Instagram handle Eric Blackheart?
Yeah, it is. I've adopted it as my first name. So yeah, Eric Blackheart, but I go by Blackheart.
Here's the most controversial and final question of the night. This one gets people riled up. What do you say, or how do you react to people who say wrestling is fake?
Come give it a try. I would love to wrestle you. Come on in. see how fake it is when you get in there and you have to run ropes and you have to take bumps. It's not fun. It's necessary. It hurts. It's not fun. But, you know, that's basically what I would have to say to them. Yeah, just come try it. You know, if you don't think it's real, it's scripted for sure. I can tell you that. There's definitely some...
Just telling a story.
Yeah, we're just telling a story. Just like any television show.
Yep.
It's a story that we're telling. There's highs, there's lows, there's comedy, there's drama.
Sure.
But the bumps are real. Like, if you're falling on your butt, you're falling on your butt. If you're falling on your back, you're falling on your back. If you're falling from the top of the ring to a ladder, you can't really fake that. Those ladders, there's no kidding those. So.
That's right.
Like, you know, you can't, there's some things you just can't fake. You can't fake landing on thumbtacks, you know? How do you fake that? I got a metal magnet in the back of my back, and this is just sticking under skin? No, that's not how it works. That stuff is legitimate, and there's definitely a risk involved. So you got to understand what you're getting into when you get into a ring.
Absolutely. Yeah. Well, all right, that's all we got for you today. I appreciate you coming
out.
Thank
you so much.
It's been a pleasure going down your career, some XAWA history, XW history. You want to check out more of Blackheart, XCW's YouTube page, XC Wrestling 1, right where this video that you're seeing is right now. Also, check out XAWA. You have weekly worldwides.
Yep,
and then you also have some pretty big events coming up in 2020, I assume.
Yep.
So check them out there. Until next time, I'm Fletch. Thank you for joining us. See you next time, Galaxy.